Hello, guys. This is Dr. Lior Barrell. I sound a little bit like an echo right now, only because I emptied out pretty much my entire location. As you can see, I'm doing a lot of construction work. That's why it's a little bit hard. So I did some more research on why Nintendo is actually, their stocks are plummeting. And, you know, some people are writing, well, you know, stocks go up and down. But no, this is actually consistent. As I told you guys before, it went from like 5% to 8%, and now it's 16%. And it's a constant going down for that. God, I hate these little freaking particles here. It's like I'm like looking at them now as I'm cleaning. So the thing is, the major issue that we're having right now with Nintendo is... you know, the why factor. Now, some people are attributing it because, oh, Nintendo said they're looking for a successor to, let's say, the 3DS, which is bullcrap, as I am going to be telling you right now on the video before. The one I released is about the 3DS, why I don't think they're going to come out with a new 3DS, and why I don't know why people are so excited about it when, obviously, there was no confirmation about this whatsoever, and the way he said it, and also, if you look at their business plan, they're marketing the Nintendo Switch as their new, you know, successor. If anything, they're going to come out, like I said, with a smaller Nintendo Switch. So I don't think that's an issue. Then they said, well, you know, right now it's the summer, and right now it's the best time to sell the stock. As a stock, as a stockholder in a lot of stock, actually, in Disney stock and Coca-Cola, Pepsi stock, all this stuff. But the thing is, yes, that could be true, but that's not true because it wouldn't be at that astronomical rate and it wouldn't be a constant down. A nice bell curve is the way that's healthy, but this is just like dwindling down. Like, you're literally seeing it going down and crashing. And there's a lot of reasons for it. Number one, as a major reason, as I told you guys, is, you know, and there's a new one that I'm going to tell you right now about, which is what the title is about. But, it's the E3 was extremely weak. Now, as an investor, anybody who invests in games or whatever, there's some people that know games, and there's a lot of stock investors that don't know anything about games. They want to know what the future is. They send their analysts out. And if you go out and you see, like I said in my other video, you're going out to E3 or you're seeing the Nintendo Direct, the poor Nintendo Direct, where they're just emphasizing one game, which is Super Smash Brothers, okay, which is, by the way, like a port that's just more, you know, extensive. So you're looking at that and you're like, oh, gee, another port Nintendo is releasing. Nothing really new about this. Just, I mean, a little bit, you know, it's like you got all your DLC characters lined up and you get better improved graphics, but this is another crappy port. Like, it's not crap, but they're looking at it that way. They're saying it's another crappy port, even though I'm a big fan of the Smash Brothers franchise. Not a lot of people are, really, okay? And a lot of people were actually really let down by the Direct. And, of course, Nintendo answered to that by saying, well, don't worry, we're coming out with another Direct before the end of the year. But as a stock person, you're looking at that and you're like, wait a second, here's all these games, but they're kind of steamrolling them because they only speak a little about it. And then they make like hours, they're talking about Smash Brothers. So what the hell's going on over here? So as an investor, as an investor, you're going to see this. You have to actually, kind of understand it, what shoes they're in. And they're looking at it as profitable, but then they're seeing something like that, and they're like, what the hell? So Nintendo's releasing another series of crap, another series of ports, and nothing new. And they're looking at the forums. They have analysts, and the forums, everybody's saying how weak it was and what they expected. Even freaking Yoshi wasn't even announced, which everybody thought was going to come out already, and of course it didn't. So you're seeing all of this garbage, and you're saying, my God, all they're doing is for Smash Brothers. Now, I like Smash Brothers, but my cousin, for example, doesn't. And there's a lot of people that don't give a crap about Smash Brothers. They don't really care for it. They wanted to see other games. I even know people on forums that were talking about a new Zelda coming out, which I also was talking about how that's not going to happen only in probably in 2019. Even though they do release every year, usually their thing, sometimes two every year, I don't think they're going to allow that to come out just yet. Yes, I do believe they're working on it, but it's not going to be in 2018. But there's a lot of people that were let down and also commented on the forums, where the hell's another Zelda game? Why isn't there a Punch-Out game, which I would freaking kill for. I love Punch-Out. Why isn't there new games? Where's Bayonetta 3? Everything was talking about. None of these things are being talked about. No new Mario. No new, Donkey Kong. Everything was a freaking port. Well, the Mario Odyssey wasn't, but I'm saying everything was a freaking port. Even if you want to get technical, Zelda Breath of the Wild is technically a port. I mean, even though it came out for both systems, you got to look at it that way because it's still in the old gen thing. So Nintendo's really horrible in their marketing. Extremely horrible. I mean, we could all agree with this, that there's something wrong with them in that respect. That they just don't, it doesn't seem that they're listening to their customers. I don't think they are, because their forums are loaded with complaints and all kinds of crap. So I enjoy my Switch, but now there's a major issue that's happening. Not particularly with mine, but with a lot of people. And I'm going to show you pictures of them. So basically, this thing, when you don't have proper cooling, okay, like I have an air conditioner on, I have stuff like that when I'm playing. I even like air conditions on during the winter, so I mean, I'm probably a little bit weird when I'm saying this. But what happens is, obviously, I didn't even think about it, but obviously this is what the issue is. With the overheating in docks, now, like I told you, I'm a portable guy, so I like playing it mostly portable, even though I have my dock right in front of my 43-incher, and hurrah, you know, I really like it. But I like taking this on the go, so I don't really have overheating issues. Now, if you guys remember, another major thing that paralyzed Nintendo was a lot of people don't want to make the jump due to their stupidity. And by that, I mean them coming out with a Tegra chip that they knew, okay, everybody knows it's all over unless something stupid with them, that they did, that everybody knows there's going to be, like, you could put a Trojan in that shit. You can hack it. You can easily hack it. It's open everywhere for any coder to just go right into it and hack, which is what's happening right now. So these stock guys are looking at it and saying, oh my God, already the hacking community is getting huge. There's people selling, you know, these little things you put right in and you could hack really easily. You could go on and you don't even have to bend the pins or 3D print like the ones I have. You don't even need to do that. You have these things that go right into the USB, and everybody's hacking it and playing it. They even showed that you could play free games on it now, that it's possible. But they have emulators on it, okay? What did I tell? I said this from the beginning. I said Nintendo screwed up when they screwed up that virtual console. When they started saying, we're not going to do it, that's the biggest, stupidest, dumbest thing they could have ever done. Because if they would have sold, like the PS Vita, as stupid as they were, but they sold PlayStation 1 games, okay, and PSP games, and they made a fortune out of it. They could have done the same with Nintendo 64. They could have done the same, but I know they want to market their classic Nintendo 64, which, by the way, not a lot of people really give a damn, since GoldenEye, due to its, you know, Rare being conquered by Microsoft and all of this stuff, they're not, but Nintendo and Microsoft are playing nice. It is possible, but again, with the release, I don't think there's, if there's going to be a release, there's not going to be GoldenEye. Okay, so everybody rather play everything on the Nintendo Switch, on a hacked Nintendo Switch, on the Nintendo 64 emulator, and be able to play all of that. They're missing out on so much business that they have no idea what they're doing. They would have made a fortune. And stockholders are seeing this, and they're looking how many people were so upset, especially when a lot of Nintendo reps were saying, oh yeah, don't worry, especially in Nintendo world. Yeah, virtual console's coming out. Virtual console's coming out. Virtual console's coming out. That's all they talk about, and guess what? It's not out. And now it's pretty much canceled. And they're doing it in a streaming service, which is beyond stupid, because you can't own these games unless you have the subscription, and when the subscription expires, so does your games. It doesn't make any sense. They could have made a fortune out of it, but instead they went that kind of way. Nintendo's lame brain, stupid business ideas, okay? And now on top of it, a new thing came out. You remember Bendgate and all this other crap that Nintendo had, bending issues and warping issues because of overheating and all this crap and all this nonsense? Well, guess what, guys? Another big issue. When it overheats, okay, I didn't have any warping issues, I could tell you that. But again, I didn't buy it close to launch date. So I personally don't have any issues with cracking or anything like that. But now there's a new thing, cracking. Okay, now obviously this thing makes sense for it to crack. Now I'm going to tell you why. What happens is it's just like a filling. Well, how come they tell you never get the silver, you know, the mercury fillings ever, because it destroys your teeth? Because what happens when it goes from hot to cold to hot to cold, it expands, decreases till it blows up your teeth. And it goes exactly the same over here. That's why they say get the white one. Okay, so the same thing here. What happened is it overheated. Then a person would play again. So it would go cold, hot, cold, hot. And then eventually you would have like these hair cracks on it. Now, obviously, if you're on warranty, even if you have a hair crack, I recommend get a new fucking one. You know, get a new freaking one. That's all I'm going to say. Get a new one and deal with it. If you guys are out of warranty, you're kind of screwed. So far, that's what I'm thinking about, because there's people on forums that said they sent it, they called for an RMA, and they actually told them, no, well, it's not our problem, and blah, 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 blah. Now, this is a problem that Nintendo has. This is a manufacturing problem. So for them not to allow you to give to get your money back is ridiculous. I mean, it's just stupid, and already shows you that they have no care for their customers at all, right? Especially when they had things, when they were telling you any of these USBs could charge them, you could charge it with your Samsung charger, because it's USB-C, and then suddenly they're like, no, only a particular C could work after their update that pretty much screwed everything up. So they're going to say that, and they're going to be like, oh, that's what it is. And guess what? That already screwed up a lot of confidence in their customers. A lot of customers already didn't care about even getting a new one because they lost all their saves and everything, so they end up selling it on eBay. I mean, you have never seen this many used Switches being sold as they are today, because people didn't give a damn to play the game all over again. They were frustrated, as they should be, and they sold it and couldn't deal with this crap anymore. And that's why I released it based on my investigation, which I gave you. I released a video that I told you. The revision 2, which is this one, which they claim is not a revision, but it is a revision. Trust me, if you actually take it apart, you'll see that the serials and everything is completely wrong, even though the serials are different in every Switch, but they have a certain, you know, number that you're going to see that is completely out of whack in the other ones. So what happened is, near launch date, a lot of these Switches, after the update, got, you know, froze, got cracked, got this, got that, all this horrible, you know, horrible things that cracked them in, bricked. And what happened is, all these horrible things lost people, especially on the Wii U side. They don't want to make the jump until Nintendo straightens out, which they don't feel is right now. Okay, and I made that video to show them that it is good, because the revision 2, what Nintendo should have said it was, which it is, they should have said, well, we're doing a recall. It would have hurt them a little bit. We're doing a recall for all the ones that bought it near launch date. Give it to us back before you brick it, and we'll transfer the data and everything for you, so you don't have to worry about anything, and then we'll just give you a new one, whether the warranty expired or not. Do you understand? But the thing is, they didn't do that. And now, in fact, they changed their warranty, basically saying that you're screwed if you're out of the warranty or whatever, and you use the different USB, whatever, they're going to know, which is, by the way, bullcrap, because I'm going to tell you one thing, because there's even people on the regular dock that charged it and it bricked, okay, on the original one. So how could they tell the difference when they both actually overload and reset? I don't think it actually blows the chip, because I took it apart. I think it just does a reset and they could only unlock it. But the thing is, they just now said they're not dealing with that, that that goes against their warranty service, even though, again, manufacturing issue, and they're not owning up to the responsibilities, and they're not owning up to what they've done. And I think that's what, overall, a lot of people are very vocal about, and the stock, you know, stockholders are sending their internet, you know, research, and they're all looking and saying, why? Wow, Nintendo is not a trustworthy thing. I mean, you even have third-party systems that are now, you know, third-party companies that are, you know, Nintendo's walking on eggshells right now with. Okay, like, for instance, EA. Not that I really give a crap, but EA, they're really walking on eggshells with them. And all of these things you got to take into consideration, that as a stock investor that hires people to actually do marketing research, or you're looking at, even as a stock investor, on marketing research, and you're seeing nothing but complaints, a poor direct, Bendgate, and you remember when you put it on the dock, it scratches. I put the glass protector. I never actually had an issue with scratching even before I had that glass protector. So again, I think it has to do with the early systems. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. But the thing is, I put the glass protector just in case. But again, it scratches. Another manufacturing problem, and nothing to fix it. You understand? And they're not owning up to it. They're just gets, you know, that thing that you put on it. That, it's so stupid. It doesn't make any sense. And all of these things taken into consideration. And now add to it cracked backs and cracked things, which I showed you guys in the pictures here. When you get all of these things coming together in a week direct of all these new games that are supposedly supposed to come out, and then you get screwed and you're like, well, all these games look like crap because they're just speeding through it, even though it doesn't, but they're speeding through it and they're steamrolling it, and all they're doing is pressing and pushing in, as always, Nintendo, common Nintendo, putting all their eggs in one basket, going just after Smash Brothers instead of talking about other games for the stockholders and for the customers. Because remember, Nintendo needs to realize if you screw over the customers won't buy it. And if they don't buy it, your stocks come coming crashing down. That's what happens. And stockholders know this crap. They know that Nintendo now has another issue with cracked, plastic, on their thing. And I understand Nintendo made their, their systems and stuff to cut all corners so they can, market it cheaper. I get that. But the thing is, there's no marketing research done. They have a non-existing marketing research and no quality control. I do not see quality control at all existing in Nintendo. Okay, the people who even plan to put the first Tegra in there, which everybody already were talking about that it's easy to hack. Okay, and they have it on there. Okay, another thing that's an issue is the what's going on. Before they release updates, they need to understand that they got to release ways to back up your crap before you release any update. Okay, that's just common freaking sense. And they didn't do that. So what happens is they release an update, screws everybody's Nintendo Switch that had it in the early, that were early adopters of it, the people that put their faith in the system. They screwed them over and pretty much lost their diehard fans, because these people just sold their Nintendo Switch and didn't give a crap, and, started saying, oh, well, it's your fault. Even though it's a manufacturing problem, they're making it seem like it is our fault. And a lot of people are vocal about this, and because of that, nobody is buying into the Switch. Okay, if portability is not an issue, I wouldn't have upgraded to the Switch. I'm telling you the absolute truth. I told you. Portability is a big issue for me. And one of the biggest things that I wanted, one of the reasons why I bought it, is Zelda, Mario, and WWE. Zelda and Mario were awesome games, but guess what? WWE 2K18 was a stinkeroo. Again, no quality control. And people are blaming 2K and blaming all these people. Yeah, they suck, but that's... Who gave the green light, people? It's Nintendo. Okay, and fanboys got to stop, protecting them, because that's what Apple's client base did, and that's why they started advancing extremely slow. When people started calling them out on it and saying what everybody already knew, what they did with the battery, and that they made the battery go dead in like seconds with their updates, so you'd be forced into an upgrade, which every Apple owner, including myself, I was an Apple owner up to iPhone 5, and I just said the hell with it and went with the Note because of this issue. Because I was sick and tired of seeing the same repeated crap being released and me being forced into buying it. And this is exactly what's going on with the fanboys of Nintendo. Instead of calling them up on it, and I'm a big fan of Nintendo. I had it since I have NES, N64. You understand? I have them all. But I'm not going to be happy and make excuses for their shortcomings. I'm going to call them out on it. And you, as fanboys, should do the same if you care. If you even give a damn about this company, you would do the same. Because if you call them out, they will improve and change. Okay, there is no excuse for this. These are manufactured errors. And they're basically saying it's your fault. And people that had cracked, the screen, whatever, not screens, but here, the cracked backs. They were sending, telling Nintendo about it, and they acted like they didn't know anything about it. And you know what? Knowing Nintendo's quality control, they probably didn't know anything about it. But the point is, when you're seeing an epidemic like that, like look at Samsung, what they did with the Note 7, even though it was found out to be a conspiracy that Apple probably did, because obviously what happened afterwards, after the recall, nobody had an issue with their, those who kept the Note 7 had zero issue with blowing up batteries. Okay? And they still took it upon themselves, and Samsung basically said, we screwed up, guys, send it back, get your refund and get another one, and we'll get a full refund or whatever, and that's it. And they even sweetened the pot at T-Mobile, where they even gave me another one for like half off almost, yeah. And Samsung did it too. But that's what it means, like how Samsung took care of their customers, how they cared about their customers. It's non-existent in Nintendo, okay, non-existent. And that's the sad part. It is really, really sad that they don't see how important customers are. They're concentrating on getting hacked. I understand that. They're concentrating on their third-party partnerships. I understand that. They're concentrating on their stock market, on the stockholders. I understand that. But you're forgetting one thing. The third party doesn't give a crap about you if you don't cater to your customers, because the customers buy your damn products, okay? The stockholders will not give a living daylights out of you if you don't see that there is more demand than supply. If there's more supply than demand, then the stockholders are screwed. And they're not going to invest in Nintendo, because that's the way it is. Again, the root of everything that you guys are needing to do is to support your client base, especially those who were early adopters, okay? Not myself. I wasn't an early adopter, and I got the better system. But the thing is, those who had faith in your damn fucking company, okay? Who had faith in your company... And I'm sorry, I'm like really pissed off with this because it's so freaking obvious. But those who had faith in your company gave up their money and time to go out there and get your Switch and freaking even pay double and triple the amount on eBay just because they loved your damn company and they loved your system, they loved your products. And you basically told them to screw off. It's your fault. Okay, that's what you basically said. And don't act like you're surprised why your stocks are crashing. That's the reason why it's happening. Nobody gives a crap because they think this thing is all faulty. Mine is not, as I told you, that's revision 2. You guys should have said, Nintendo, guys, anybody who bought it close to launch date or within that thing, within this serial number range, return it for a full refund and or get a replacement. Do what Samsung did. Okay, and you guys would have sent it out and everybody would have been on board and said, okay, here's the new system, now everything is great. But what you guys are doing is everybody that holds a Wii U and doesn't know if they want to upgrade, they're looking at you guys saying, we screwed up, the manufacturing sucks, everything sucks, our marketing research sucks, our quality control is non-existent, but guess what? It's your fault. And all of these big loyal fans end up selling their system and said to hell with Nintendo. And I was a big Apple fan, and when they started screwing people over, I gave it up. I was a big fan. I was a fanboy, but not a fanboy like, you know, making excuses for them. But I didn't give a crap after the fifth one, even though now they're releasing good phones. But the thing is, that's what's happening right now. You are screwing over your loyal client base. And you're blaming it on your clients. You're blaming it on your customer, your end user, which is probably the stupidest thing you could have ever done. What I would have said is, you know what? You have an issue. We know you know, get a quality control that actually works. Actually, if I don't even think you have one. Get a quality control unit and see that your system freaking blows in the early ones. Like I said, I have absolutely zero issue, not even overheating with this. So again, I don't think it is the new systems. Again, it could be. But everybody that's complaining even about the cracked screens, I mean screens, the cracked backs, are people who were early adopters. Again, now they're like, okay, we got the USB, we got a new one, we got the, but you know, it didn't break or whatever. So they're like, we dodged that bullet and we're using the regular Nintendo dock. We're feeling great. Everything is working. And now, lo and behold, we have bending. Oh my God, we have scratching in the docks. Oh, wait a second. We have cracks now. This is the stupidest thing you could do, Nintendo. And really, I just don't get it. And don't make it seem like it's your customer's fault. That is the biggest mistake you could ever make. And this is why your stocks are plummeting. And this is why you might be the biggest failure if you don't address this immediately. Understand that the early systems looks like it is the problem. That is the issue. Everything else works. So why don't you just own up to the issue? Take the damn systems back, do a freaking recall, take a little hit, the stocks will take a hit for the recall as Samsung did and everything did after, but afterwards, you get the new systems out, the new revisions, okay, revision 3, which you're going to call revision 2, even though this is revision 2, but release the new systems, okay, and everything will start to rise again. And everybody's like, well, Lior, the sales are going great in America, yes, but America is not the world. And the United States, yes, we're doing great. Okay, and places like Australia, they're not. And places around the world, they're not. Places like Israel, places like, there's worldwide markets that you guys are not thinking, all over the Middle East, you're not thinking about that, and that's the major issue. Worldwide market is what matters. They have millions to sell, but they're not going to sell it. So they have more supply than demand. Common sense of any stockholder would be to bail. It's just as simple as that. And their stocks are crashing. Okay, 16 points. And now it's going... It doesn't seem to show any improvement. So anyways, let me know what you guys think down below. If what I'm talking about makes sense. I even want some fanboys up on here because I'm a fan of Nintendo. But I want to see, and I want you guys not to make excuses for their shortcomings here. But actually explain, explain to yourselves to understand what's going on. If you like this company, you cannot make excuses for them. You need to call it out the way it is. Their customers came who had faith in them and bought these systems early and got screwed. There's no way around it. It's a manufacturing problem. And they're making it seem like it's the customer's fault. Anyways, let me know what you guys think down below. As always, self-funded here. Going to be doing reviews, ton more reviews for Mega Man 11 when it comes out. Smash Brothers, I already pretty much pre-ordered all of those, so those are going to come out too. As always, now I'm releasing, as we speak, every Sunday, how to build a gaming computer on the cheap. So be sure to check that out. And after that, I'm going to show you guys how to build a helmet. I'm doing Starkiller, but you could do also Iron Man. It's the same concept on a 3D printer from beginning to end with color and weathering and all that. I'm going to show you guys how to do that in the mini series because you guys requested it. And another big request was to make a gaming desk, which is going to be the next mini series that's going to come out after that. So definitely, if you guys like what you see, support the channel by definitely liking, subscribing, and hitting that bell button. As always, I don't do Patreon or any of that crap. I have a job. I do this. The reason I released this channel is mainly to give truth and information out because I am sick of hearing the crap that people are being paid to say. And that's why I released this channel. And I'm grateful to all you guys that are subscribing to here and to you guys who are writing comments down below and letting me know what can improve, what is wrong, what is this, what is that, and what you like and all of that. I really dig that. I do like when you give me a like or anything. It improves the channel, makes it better, and I want it to be a giant community that we all can come and just sit down and talk and debate and all kinds of stuff. I cover an array of things from, you know, psychology to spiritual guidance to technology reviews and unboxings and video games, as I, you know, mostly Nintendo Switch and PlayStation 4. That's what we do here. So definitely show some love. Definitely like, subscribe, hit that bell button. Have a good one, y'all. Take care. Bye.